All right, everybody, I'm back with an update video on the current status of the see-through engine project on turbo, nitro, and EFI. Everyone has been asking for an update on this project for months, and since the live stream yesterday didn't quite work out,
hopefully everybody's gonna like this live stream.
I figured I would follow up with a video in full 4K so you can get a nice good look at what I got going on here. I'm gonna show you each piece of the project right now, but first and foremost, I want to show you what ECU I'm using. This is the engine management system, and it's a MS3 Pro by AMP EFI. These guys assured me that I would be able to adapt this to the single cylinder Briggs and Stratton right here, and sure enough, for me, it was pretty straightforward, super flexible ECU, and I have some tuning experience, so it wasn't too hard. I'm gonna show you how all that is hooked into the PC in a moment. But before that, I wanna answer one of the questions from the live stream, and that is, why did this project take me so long? One of the reasons it took so long is for the last 6 months, I've been busy filming a show called Storm Stories. I'm uploading some of those behind the scenes videos to my personal channel. I'll leave a link to that channel in the description below if you want to check that out, but that's one of the reasons this took me so long. The second reason is this timing wheel right here. I had a lot of issues with this, and this brings me to my second question from the live stream, and that is, what was one of the biggest challenges of this build? And that would be this timing wheel right here. First timing wheel I had was this big bulky timing wheel. It just didn't feel or look safe, but this is how I have it set up right now. I wanted to adapt the timing wheel that was gonna work, be safe, and have good resolution. And by resolution, I mean accuracy. The more teeth, the more accurate. And this is probably the most important part of this build, because this is how the engine management system knows what position the engine is at any given moment and is able to calculate things like ignition timing, fuel injector timing. I was really excited about this, so I'm gonna show you how it works real quick. Then I'm gonna move on to showing you the sensors and how I have everything set up. But I finally built the starter. In the previous episodes, everybody told me I needed a starter, so I finally built one with this drill and extension and a socket, but hey, it works. So I wanna show you how this pickup works. I'm gonna spin the engine, just watch the RPM, and that's how the computer knows the RPM of the engine, through this sensor and this wheel. Here it goes. It's as simple as that.
I'm gonna move on to all the sensors now. And the first one I was excited about was this coolant temperature sensor. For some reason, I mounted it right in the block right there. And this, since this is air cooled, I kind of just made sure it was touching the fin right here. And I mean, I think it's gonna work out pretty good. It's definitely gonna give us a good idea of what the temperature of that cylinder is. And if it doesn't work, I'll just machine something in there, but we'll see how that goes. Now I'm gonna show you all of the sensors. This is a air temperature sensor, I believe, or an airflow sensor. I have to look it up. It's been a while since I ordered it. This is the throttle position sensor. This was the next sensor I was really excited about when I got it to work. And I can show you this one in real time too.
This is how the throttle position sensor works. This would be at idle, full throttle, idle, full throttle.
Now, this is the fuel injector. It's a 1000cc injector. You know, some people were commenting that it's kind of big, and yeah, it's kind of big, but to be honest, I'm running nitromethane most of the time, so I think it'll be all right. This thing right here, this was sent by Jesus, because I was looking for this valve, and I needed a four-wire valve. This is the idle air control valve. So basically, this is how the engine management system controls the idle of the engine. This valve pulls open, this plunger, and it lets air into the intake. And like I said, this was sent by Jesus, because I was looking for this thing forever, and some guy, my neighbor said it was just some guy, he walked by and dropped this on my porch. It was the weirdest thing, one of the weirdest things that's ever happened to me. I was looking for this thing, I couldn't find it. And yeah, true story, she just called me. She's like, you know, some guy left some weird thing on the porch out of nowhere. It was really weird. But anyway, onto the ignition coil. I'm just gonna use a single ignition coil to begin with. And then I'm gonna move on to my MSD red box. I'm gonna show everybody what multi-spark discharge is with the high-speed camera. And then this is my setup. I have my battery. I have my fuel pump right here, high pressure fuel injector pump, my oil pump for the turbo, and last but not least, my ECU or EMS. And I have a blow off valve here from an Eclipse. I might try to hook that up and get that to work. Something else I want to show you is the intake. I'm going to be removing this entire intake tube from the engine and building a see-through throttle body that's going to house the injector, the idle air control valve right there, and the air temperature sensor. I think it's going to be super cool to see in real time how the fuel injector works and maybe even how that idle air control valve works. The last thing I want to show you, look at these wires. There's like a ton of wires here that I have to hook up, and lucky for me, the ECU came with this little reference card for all the wiring, and this makes it surprisingly easy because everything's kind of listed and color-coded, and yeah.
I think I covered everything. I just want to answer one more question people had about this, and that is, what am I going to do with the EFI system after this engine blows up? Because everybody, including myself, is confident this thing is going to blow sky high in the next episode. So my plans are, when I build this thing tomorrow, I'm going to make it all modular where I can just disconnect the harness and move it to another engine. And in this case, it's going to move to the second version of this see-through engine, which is already done. That episode has been done already, but I need to release this episode first, and this episode is not done yet. So that's what I'm going to focus on now. That's about it. Don't forget to check out Storm Stories on my personal channel. Leave a link in the description below. Tell me what you think about that. Hopefully the next thing you'll see of this engine is a finished episode. Thanks for watching. Thanks for your patience, and yeah, see you soon.